the best way of doing it. And I think this is completely taken to another level.
Obviously, the collaboration of me and him and Force behind us helps Rocky Handsome. It's definitely an advantage when it comes to release. But we, as individuals, we had a much higher responsibility that if we've created some sort of a name as a team, then we have to take it to the next level. In fact, it was in a way disadvantage for us in the sense while working that we had to constantly remind ourselves that it has to be way better than Force or our earlier collaboration. But yes, it definitely helps for the film that we are working together.
You know, one more question. Marketing and promotions are an integral part of filmmaking today. This film has been marketed really intelligently, you know. There's a teaser coming out, then the songs, then the trailer. Whose plan was it and how creatively are you involved, John, in the marketing campaign? Like, releasing it 3 weeks prior to the...
I think, see, that's a very good question. I'll tell you, first of all, I'll give credit to Digi Osmosis, which is doing our digital campaign, Spot On, which is doing our on-ground campaign, and Parag and our entire PR team. But outside of that, Rahul Nanda is someone who has been very instrumental in actually making this happen. He's been a think tank, and outside of that, I think Sunil and his entire team with Nishi and me, we've actually, each one of us has been completely involved. Because if you see, this is not a multi-starer. This is just three or four of us sitting here. So each one of us has taken every little photograph into account saying, 3 weeks pehle ye release hona chahiye, uske baad 2 weeks pehle ya 3 din pehle ye release hona chahiye, 2 din pehle ye. So even if you see the trailer launch, everything has been, every little thing has been taken into account. So we've actually been very careful with the marketing, but we've also been very honest with the film. We've not tried to show another film that it is. This is Rocky Handsome, this is what you're going to get, and please come and watch it.
Nishikant sir, aapke right idhar, main TV se Ritesh actually, just one second, an apology. Just Right Studios was done visual promotions as a big hand. The way our various things are looking on the audiovisual form.
Yeah, Manish, I think fantastic. I just gave him a big hug today for a fantastic presentation.
सर आपसे सवाल है कि जब ये कैरेक्टर लिखे जा रहे थे तभी से आपका डिसाइड था कि आप ही विलेन बनेंगे या कोई और भी दिमाग में
वेरी ऑनेस्टली नहीं था मैंने सोचा भी नहीं था कि मैं विलेन का किरदार करूंगा इनफैक्ट हमारे मेरे एक बहुत करीबी दोस्त हैं जो एक्टर नहीं लेकिन उनका फेस बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग था तो मैं उनके पीछे पड़ा था कि आप ये रोल करो तो बोला हाँ मैं सोचता हूँ ये वो थोड़ा क्या है कि रोल मैं तो मैंने एक्टिंग कभी की नहीं मैं संभाल लूंगा सिर्फ आप ही रोल करो क्योंकि आपका फेस बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग करते करते शूटिंग का दौर आ गया शूटिंग स्टार्ट हो गई और वो लास्ट मिनट में बोला मैं नहीं कर सकता वो थोड़ा सा ये हो गया दोस्त है मेरा बहुत करीबी तो जब 2 दिन रह गए थे तब तक कास्टिंग हुई नहीं थी और जॉन सर की डेटें थी हमारे पास मतलब सारे एक्टर्स की डेट्स थी तो वी कुडंट चेंज द स्केड्यूल एंड इट वॉज द थॉट कि क्या करें एंड इनफैक्ट मी एंड माई डायरेक्शन डिपार्टमेंट हमने सोचा ये रिस्क ले गया और दे ऑल्सो सेट के आपको कर लेना चाहिए एंड आई जस्ट गॉट टू थ्री डेज टू प्रिपेयर द लुक बट आई ऑलवेज न्यू द कैरेक्टर बिकॉज क्योंकि मैंने लिखा हुआ था किरदार तो मुझे किरदार पता था लेकिन वो कैसे दिखेगा कैसे चलेगा ये मुझे तकरीबन 2-3 दिन में मिले एंड वी इमीडिएटली स्टार्टेड शूट
जॉन आपकी बॉन्डिंग कैसी रही एज अ डायरेक्टर आपको पहले डायरेक्ट करते थे और अब को स्टार एज अ वर्क कर रहे हैं
आई थिंक इट्स अमेजिंग क्योंकि निशि के साथ निशि जब भी मुझे ब्रीफ करने आता है सेट पे बिफोर द शॉट वो मुझे देखता है एंड आई लुक एट हिम एंड ही सेज यू गॉट इट नो आई से हां गॉट इट सो इट्स हम लोग दोनों ऑटो पायलट पे रियली आई थिंक इट्स अ ब्यूटीफुल रिलेशनशिप और मैं मानता हूँ कि देर आर फ्यू रिलेशनशिप्स दैट आर वेरी स्पेशल और उनमें से देर इज अ डायरेक्टर एक्टर रिलेशनशिप जब भी उनका एक रिलेशनशिप बनता है आई थिंक इट्स वेरी स्पेशल और निशि और मेरा ये रिलेशनशिप बन चुका है और मैं काफी एक्चुअली मैं डरता हूँ कि वो भाग जाएगा कहीं पे ऐसे निशि लेट्स डू समथिंग सो आई एम ऑलवेज आई एम अ बिग फैन ऑफ हिज डोंबिवली फास्ट मुंबई मेरी जान लई भारी जो दृश्यम जितनी सारी फोर्स ऑफ कोर्स आवर फिल्म टुगेदर यू सी एवरी फिल्म ऑफ हिज आई थिंक निशि इज ऑनेस्टली मार्केटिंग करने की जरूरत नहीं है आप लोग फिल्म देखते हो ही इज अ फैंटास्टिक डायरेक्टर सो आई थिंक ही इज गॉट आउट समथिंग रियली स्पेशल इवन इन रॉकी हैंड्स
जॉन
John, you said you're a big fan of Sylvester Stallone. A whole lot of people were rooting for him at the Oscars this time. Were you also disappointed when he missed out?
Honestly, I was in Abu Dhabi. I didn't really follow the Oscars. But yeah, you know, when you really like somebody, you expect him to win. It's as simple as that. And he's like an underdog all the time. Johnny Abraham is an underdog.
You know, we also hear that there is some trouble with the censor board in getting them to give you a US certificate. So,
no, there was no trouble. We went to the censors, we asked for UA. They said, I think we should go with A. We respected them. We took
You're happy with that?
Yeah, absolutely.
Is it also true that this movie is inspired from a Korean film called Man from Nowhere?
It's actually an official remake of a Korean film called The Man from
Nowhere. It's official.
It's official. But we have an Indian adaptation because when you Indianize a story which you pick up from foreign culture, you need to adapt it to suit the sensibilities of the local audience. So, for all who've seen the original film, it comes in three shades. There is dark blue, there is black, and there is blue black. But our film, you've seen the trailer and you've seen the visuals. Visually, it is different, and there are elements which have been brought in.
Was it a conscious